Hello, and welcome back to the Ultra Great Awesome Amazing Permutator. We're going to jump right into things and go to the main attraction, which is Boxomania. We're going to be wrecking everything. So, it would seem that in order to avoid some collisions, we're going to need to take note of, hold on here. We're going to need to take note of the fact that this one starts without any boxes here. So you'll see that if we, you know, just turn off the rest of these inputs just for a little while. It doesn't even really matter what they are. And, you know, we're going to see that this is going to merge in just fine. So as long as we do something like this, we should be good. Yeah, so that's fine. And then, similarly, this is also going to have to merge in. So something like that. In fact, we could even shorten it a little bit more. Is that going to work? Yes, it will, because it's all going to be diagonal. So we'll just extend the pattern. As far as we can, anyway. And there might be a better way to do this, but for the time being, this will be fine. And there we go. We're going to get a nice line of boxes. They're going to be destroyed! Oh man, look at that action. We're just burning calories. Lovely. Now, before we continue on to these other puzzles and try and finish up this first page here, I'm going to go back to number 15, where last time I tried to solve it, I made a big thing where we tried to have a feedback loop, but I want to talk about solution features again and kind of a general-purpose puzzle-solving methodology talk. Because as you remember from last time, what I did was I fed these things in such a way that I would do a feedback loop on these left two outputs, and only this third output would go to this center thing here, which would then split it up and send things out to the right, the middle, and the left. But because this right-hand output is the only thing that actually goes to the out, there's no way that this solution could possibly work no matter how well I split things up. Even if I managed to split up each of these nine individual cubes perfectly, there's no way this could possibly work. And the reason for that is you have to keep in mind the constraints of this particular game and not any other game. You have a finite number of boxes and you never get to repeat them or do any kind of loop with them. So that means you have to keep in mind the end of the puzzle. I've been kind of doing that implicitly with some of the other puzzles, but I really have to bring this point to the forefront here. Always keep in mind what the last thing your puzzle is going to be doing is. In this case, you know, you could put three boxes in here and send one out here, but then there would come a point where we would only have two boxes left, and there would be absolutely no way we could get them to go on this third track here, because you just can't fill up the accumulator anymore. And there's no way to have three boxes that all go to the end, because the way this was set up is that we would only feed them out one at a time. So, no matter how well this was set up, there was no way it could work. So I have an idea for an alternative, as soon as I stop this and clear it all up. So that topology is just not going to work, no matter what. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to do something similar, but in such a way that when we have an accumulator out here, all three of these outputs, like this one, and this one, all of these are going to have to wind up in here eventually, because the last three outputs, like the last box, has to go into this accumulator. Those last three, whatever they wind up being, all have to go out here, feed into here, and then get sent out here. So, no matter what feature, like what kind of delays, what kind of lengths, what kind of arrangement of these conveyor belts we have, that's gonna have to be a feature of the solution, is all three of these are gonna have to connect to this. So with that in mind, hopefully we can set up something interesting here. With that in mind, since none of these connect to here, this has to connect to this, this has to connect to this, this has to connect to this. So basically, it's just going to be a matter of figuring out what order I want to feed these in. So this has to go first. And then following that, we would want another red, ideally, but we can't really have that. But what we can do is we can split these up. So once again, split-ups come to the rescue, and I think it's going to be kind of like that compression-decompression thing, where we're going to want to have a short path, a medium path, and a long path. So with that in mind, we probably want to put this, like, over to the side. This will be our short path, this will be our medium path, and this will be our long path. But we still want to have enough room that we can send this one in first, because it just makes sense to do that. So ideally what we'll want is, this will be our short path, so we'll want a red to go in here, followed by a yellow, followed by a blue. So this one, that means that, that seems to imply that this should go in first, followed by this. So can we might be able to, well, it's alright, we'll just flip it. So this will go in first, then this will get delayed, and this one will be the last one. So that way, this front object, the red will go in here, then this front yellow will go in here, and then finally this front blue will also go in here. And then this is going to have to be the direct path. Well, that's a little awkward. Fine. Let's do it this way. Hopefully I won't need any more rows than this. So we'll get a red, then we'll get a yellow in here, and then we'll get a blue in here. So this will race up here, and this will wind up in the in this bottom accumulator first. Then we're just gonna have to see about what we get out the remainder bits here. So, you know, let's say we get that path, and then this even longer path. So let's just see what we wind up with on the other tracks when we try this. So this will give us a red, a yellow, and a blue, which will fill up quite nicely. And then we're gonna get a yellow, a blue, and a red. Interesting. Now if we could merge these tracks together, the way we have things set up is that right now we have the basic, because of the way we split these up, we fed these in like immediately one after another. We could increase the delay between them to increase the delay when, like, see, this is filled in like immediately after this. So that's why at the end here, like, this is separated by 3 and that's separated by 4. But we could increase that. We could, like, merge these tracks together. So for example, that's the thing, though. If we increase the delay too much, like if we separate these out too much, then that also increases the length of this sequence. See, I was thinking, like, what if we merge this, but that's, like, we want to pair things up in kind of a weird way. So sure, so far so good. That's gonna merge in an awkward way, but that's how you would separate them out. So now I'm just saying, like, how are we gonna mix them so that they rotate properly? Because clearly there's not gonna be a one-to-one correspondence anymore. And this is a stream, so all three of these are gonna fall right one after another. So for example, I could put this in and then try and get this in before this comes in. Let's see, what would this do? Just as an example. That came in too fast, actually, so we would want to delay that by one, I guess, or two. So, sure, if I could increase the delay, get a blue in here, then probably this would come in first anyway, so... But yeah, I think that's sort of the right idea. The problem is, this blue would also have to be in a good timing, and like this would end up with like a yellow. But if like this final blue could be delayed quite a long time, yeah, I'm starting to think this is probably what he's talking about, the author is talking about with the sheet of paper, where we might have to write down some conveyor belt lengths. Because if I just trial and error this, this might take a long time. But let's just see what the effects are on our production, if, say, for example, we delay this by a little bit. By, like, one, and this also. Because that will have the effect of accelerating these three with respect to the other six. So then, that way, we will get it red and that again, but that's not going to change the... that's not going to change the distance of this one with respect to this one, because these are part of the same group. Yeah, because that yellow and that blue came from the same thing, so they're going to have exactly the, this and this are the same offset apart, so this and this are also going to be the same offset apart. So there's no way for this to beat this without this also beating that, and that's not what we want. So what we would want is for this blue to come in immediately afterwards, actually. Which means we want this path to be a lot shorter. Okay, well, let's try that. Well, except that's not really going to help matters, though, because that just means that we're joining up the things again. So we're just going to get this, this, and this again. Like, that has no particular... that doesn't have any particular association with it. So what we can do, again, is we can change the order. So for example, we can cause this to have a much larger delay. Except we wouldn't want that, so... So, yeah, that seems to be it. We would want to, I think, vastly increase the lengths of these paths so that, again, it's all one singular track thing. The problem with that is if we do it too much, then again, these are going to come out in the wrong order. So, maybe we don't... Yeah, that might actually be the thing. This is the direct path, but maybe we want this medium path to merge with the long path instead of the short path. Maybe that'll end up with a better topology for us. Yeah, like maybe you want the long path to be in the middle. There's, you know, who says that the long path has to be on the outside? Maybe the long path is in the middle. Okay. Let's just see what that gets us. We're just doing some experimentation here for the time being. Alright, so let's review what happened here. So the first fast one got in here, followed by the second fast one, followed by the first slow one. Or the first medium one, in fact. So maybe we want medium path to get in there a little bit faster. Let's see what that gets us. Yeah, that's not the right order. So that'll get us a one fast, then a medium, then a fast, and then, yeah, then it gets complicated because of the way I set up the timing here. Okay, this is, yeah, I think this is closer to the right solution, but yeah, there's going to be a lot of awkward path finagling, and I don't know how conducive that's going to be for an LP format, but hopefully I've at least shown that this is closer to the right idea. This could work. I just don't quite see how yet, but I'm pretty sure that this is along the right lines. But I'm gonna move on. Okay, so we did the box demolition, that's good. What's next? Okay, so we just have to turn one into five, but we only have one duplicator. And we can't have an infinite loop. Like, if we do an infinite loop, which we... That was actually part of the flavor text for some of the earlier levels, but I missed it. Like, if we just do this, you know, this will get us our five boxes, but it's never actually going to stop. Actually, I want to see what happens here. This will be useful information for later. Okay, good. That actually crashes immediately. So once this is actually done, it doesn't like that anymore. Okay, that's good enough. But even if somehow, like, this was okay, the fact that we never actually destroyed a box here would be a problem because it would never actually go away. So we need to produce terminating behavior. Which is clearly what the toggles are for. So, I think we need to only send a certain number of duplicates through. And then eventually... one of them will just go straight through. So we're going to... You know, this right-hand side is going to be our output, sure. Then we probably want most of our stuff to go through. We're going to need... and yeah, we're going to need... Like, on most of them, it'll have to go through, but then on the final, like, so that should go through here, then here, then here, and then the final one should go here, and that should give me enough boxes, I think. So, you know, these trigger things will advance our counter. And then that should give us four, I think. Yeah, it'll give us four duplicates, and then the counter block will also go straight through. So we got exactly four duplicates, because we only were able to toggle this three times. And the fourth was the pass-through, but then that also added the count. Alright, simple enough. Then what's this? Alright, so we've got... So now we need to turn two into three. But they have to share a duplicator. Well, that's not so bad. Okay, so now we have a big problem, actually. Because we need both of these to go through in a different kind of way. Like, we need to split this up, because if we feed both of these through the duplicator, then we'll have four reds, and that would be way too many reds. We can't get rid of a red. So we need one red to bypass the duplicator, one to go through. But then both of these have to go through here, but we also need to use the toggles so that like some of them go through here, some of them don't. Because similarly, the yellows also have to go through the duplicator. Two yells will come out, and the trigger will have to send through. So I think, once again, it's going to be delays to the rescue, because what we want is, alright, we're going to have to move this down a little bit so we have enough space, but what we want is for the latter half of these duplicates to arrive a lot later than these, because we want, like, a red and a yellow to arrive through here immediately, and then later on a red and a yellow arrive through here. And I don't know what that's gonna do, but I guess we'll worry about this later, but maybe we'll delay this even longer, maybe. Then this is gonna have to follow very close behind. Alright, hopefully this works. Let's just see what this does. This is the right framework, I think. Alright, so that's good. That's going to be a red and a yellow. This is also going to be red and a yellow, and this is going to be red and a yellow. In fact, this could be a little bit shorter. In fact, we actually probably want these to go through first. We will want to feed these through first and then put the later ones on here. Not that that makes too big of a difference, mind you, but some. Alright, simple enough. Once again, delays to the rescue. And we could probably crunch that up a little bit more. Let's see. Yeah, that's already about as good as it's going to be. I guess this could be a little bit more to the left, so that that way we save. We increase the length of this by one, but we decrease the length of this by more. So that's because we add one here, but we remove one from each of these, so that's better. And that'll arrive just after that. That'll arrive just after that. And it's all good. So our tile count's still a little bit high, but I'm not going to worry about it anymore. Okay, level 25, the last of the first page. We're going to need a lot of red boxes. In fact, we're going to need 10, but exactly 10. That's a bit odd. Okay, so fortunately we have these duplicators, which make our job a little bit easier. If we can just feed two through here, then that's a bit better. We're going to need to divert some. So I think this is all going to be about space management. Yeah, this is actually, yeah, this is all about, topography is going to be very important here too, just because we're not going to have a whole lot of, ways to redo this. Okay. And then this will help increase the count of something. So I think this is, again, this is sort of the right idea, but we're not quite there yet. So, you know, this will go through and it'll duplicate again. But yeah, this is gonna very much be a custom solution. So yeah, if we could fit in one more here, then we would be set, because I think instead of feeding this forward one more, we'd want to send it through one more time, I think. Or actually two more times, because we'd want one in here, then one in there, then another one in here. Yeah, that makes sense. So then we just have to figure out how to fit a four counter into this, this old big old clogged up thing. So there is just not much space here at all. This can go over here, I guess. Does that make sense? That sorta makes sense, but not really. Doesn't make a lot of sense. So far, so good. This'll keep it going. And that's it. That's it. We're done. Because one of these needs to feed back up through there, I think. Well, there's still room for that. We can move that over one. Then this can probably fit up. No, that's not gonna, it's not gonna cross over this successfully. Okay, there's still a little bit more to this than that. Yeah, I think the problem is that this is up here. This actually has to be, like, something like this, I guess, or no, is that going to be too many? That might send too many in here. Yeah, it's going to send too many. Alright, we have to have a very clear conception of what we're doing, so I think it's a good idea to just restart, just so I have an idea, like a plan from start to finish. We're going to start by going over here, I think. Yeah, there's just no room up here, so anything, there's no logic up here. Logic takes a lot of space. This would seem to be the right idea. It doesn't, like, if this goes anywhere else, then it blocks that off. Same with these. So these have to connect directly. There's no other way around that. You can feed extra ones in here. Like, feed one in here, feed one in there. I don't know why you would want to do that, but you can if you want to. That might be right, and then all of these in here? No, is that gonna, that's gonna be too many, isn't it? That's gonna be way too many. Yeah, and I haven't even provided a way to get in here, so scratch all that. I mean, I guess I could do this. That might be enough room. Then do all these custom-wise. This one gets to go all the way back up here and get fed in here. Then the rest are better. Now, see, what's the point of that? There's no point in that. If we're gonna do that, might as well do this, but, you know, then, yeah, how's, well, let's see what this does, at least. Nothing even connects to this one anymore. That's probably more like what I wanted. Except I might as well just do this if I'm gonna do that. Alright, there's no path that goes back to this, though. So sure. And then go connecting to that is an end state. So that's no good. We want that to be the last thing that happens. Alright. Yeah, so you want most of these paths to feed back into here. But this has to get taken twice, so that means that there has to be logic on this end that takes... There has to be logic on both these ends. Because there has to be logic that sends a box through here occasionally, but that has to not end after the first one goes through here, so there also has to be a logic that sends a box from here back up to here sometimes. Which means we need a little bit more space. So something like this, perhaps? So that means half of the boxes will go in here, and half of them will go back in here, and then maybe this one is responsible for propagating itself again. Which means we want this to go through first, then like the other half of this will be the last part. Similarly, like then only like two of them will go down here, or two of them will go back, and one of them's gonna have to go over here, and then another one's gonna have to go out here, I guess. Okay, that might work. If only I could actually fit that in here. Yeah, like, this is vexing, because you essentially need four rows for a trigger. You need one row to put your input conveyor, you need another row for your output conveyors, and that's it. So it's really hard. But fortunately, the fact that this is here means that the authors know that you can get this done with this little space, so there has to be a better way to do this. But like, what I want to do is connect this to a trigger, then like half of that goes here, and then half of that goes back up. Like, into this, I think. No, it's just half goes here, half goes over there. If I could make this output point out, then I would be set, but no such luck. Like, so let's just see what this does. I know it's not gonna work, but I want to see what it does. So that gets that done. This is gonna repeat. And what I need is for one of these to actually go back up. And this has to get toggled. So one of these has to go all the way back up here, I think. Right? I mean, just be like I noticed earlier, like, you could reroute other tracks into this, like I could put one in here and one in there. So if two end up out here, I could split them otherwise, but that seems way too complicated. I'm not sure if that's actually right. That doesn't seem right. But how can I make use of any more toggles? Because you can only really fit, like, a certain number. And there's not much room for feedback into this uppermost duplicate. So maybe I'm doing too much work on this one. Maybe I need to split the work, because this one's not doing much work. Yeah, that might be a bit better. Like, just duplicate this once. And so that way we'll get two in here. Maybe that'll be better. I think that will help. On the first time, this will get fed through again, and on the second time, it won't. And then that'll be the end of that. And that might actually be enough. Yeah, that might actually be enough, because then if we just get two in here, then I send two in here and two in there, and then I'm set, right? Like, won't that be enough? And plus, I need to actually, like, account for this, too. so that's mostly right. Now, if I could just send this one of these through again, and then, like, yeah, two toggles will be enough for this. One toggle to send one of the divert one of these boxes through so that it gets duplicated again. Then on the second run, it'll go through and end. And another toggle on this end that will send one of its boxes down this way so that we get that takes care of these two. And I think we'll have enough room to actually do that this time. Maybe. Just barely. So on the first run, this will send back in here. And on the other run, it just goes in here and duplicates. I think that should do it. We'll have to see. Okay, that's no good. What's that? That won't happen again. So that gets fed through. We'll get a total of three here, and that's fine. So one gets over there, and then another gets over there. That takes care of that. One final duplicate. That's not right. I think, I think this is fine. I think that'll do it. Because now on the first run, this will go straight through, so will this. That's all good. Then we'll get one more out here, coming from this one. Yeah, and then it'll get fed through again, and this will produce our last set of three. Okay, that looks good. I think we're there now. Yeah, there we go. And that's how you make 10 boxes out of one. Alright. Well, looks like we still don't have 15 solved, but I think we can go on to page 2. Alright. Okay, then. Oh, we've got a painter now. Okay. Very interesting. Okay, now we're doing some sorting. Okay. So do we get to change the color? Yes, we do. So we want reds here, we want yellows here. And we need to exchange some of these, but not all of these. So we have way too many reds, so some of them have to get turned into, some of those are gonna have to get turned into this stuff. If we can just avoid, collisions, we should be good to go. Let's move this wide, sure. Alright, so that'll make more yellows. And we need more blues. So maybe both of these have to go through the exchanger? Yeah, that actually sounds more correct. Yeah, because if this goes through, we'll get... Okay, so blue goes to red, red goes to yellow goes to blue. So it wraps around. I think that'll produce the correct ratio of boxes. Because that will produce, that'll be a total of three yellows, three blues, and three reds. There we go. Analyzer doing our job for us. You know, we had to do the job manually earlier, but now we got machines to do it for us. And that is what human progress looks like. I think we might need... Yeah, I think if we just send some It seems like we're going to need one of each of these on the other side. Probably they're going to be in opposite order, if I had to guess. Yeah, I mean, I might have to flip these, but it's going to be something like this, and then... Well, not the analyzer. So probably the analyzer actually goes on the top. Yeah, this is not going to be... Yeah, we're going to have to actually examine these very carefully. Like, we can use an analyzer on one part, but not toggle quite as easily. I guess we could use an analyzer like this. We could separate these out and then recombine them, sort of. No. We would need, like... What do we start with? We start with a red and a blue, but they're not separated, is the problem. Let's just see what happens if we do something like this, where we delay this appropriately compared to this. I want to see what these input streams look like. Let's just ignore this other half for now. It's part of the same room, but I'm not going to worry about it. I just want to see what our what it looks like. So all the blues wind up on this side, and this does start with a red. But if we could send like a single yellow over to that side, then we would be fine. Actually, that's going to be a... let's see. What's that other box? There's another blue. Yeah, so that's not quite right. I mean, yeah, it's fine, but... Like, for a minimum amount of work, we want to get one of these blues over here and one of these yellows over there. So I think we need to sort these differently. Actually, the thing is, if we can only split out the reds, if we can split out a red, then we're actually doing a lot better. Yeah, if we can, because then the reds go out early, the other colors get delayed, and then I think because of the way we're going to feed in the yellows first, then the blues, then they'll get separated out, and then they'll get sent to the toggler in a much better way. And then I think that'll help. Yeah, so then we send one, half a red, and then another yellow and a yellow and then a blue and a blue. So that takes care of that side. You know, a little inefficiently, but it does. So, if we can do something similar, then we might actually have the right idea. Yeah, because if we do a similar thing where we feed in this stream first, then followed by that stream into the toggler, what's going to end up happening is we're going to get a red, a yellow, and a blue. But if we can filter out the yellow, then we can send it out the other way, right? We're going to get three on the other side. So actually, no, we want an analyzer, right? To filter out a red, and then toggle it, and then, well, then how are we going to get separate streams? No, that's not going to work, is it? We do it like that, maybe? Let's just see what happens here. Yeah, because there's no space in between those, so I can't really, Well, I guess that's okay, actually. Yeah, because then a yellow will go over there, a blue will go over there, a red will go somewhere, it doesn't really matter. Maybe that's not quite right. Like, is that the right... Like, sure. Okay, if I could fit this red in again, then it would toggle it again. So this has to get here faster, actually. But not quite that fast. But then, by a similar argument, this red's not gonna beat, it's not gonna beat this, other kind. Because again, the relative, amount doesn't change. If this red is staying behind this set, then of course this red is gonna stay behind this set. So that's not gonna work. If I could somehow fit both of these reds in between these streams, then I would be fine, but that's not gonna work. So maybe I need to separate out a different color. No, that's not gonna help. Like, is severing out a yellow going to do any good? I don't think so. That's just gonna send two yellows over here, followed by red, blue, red, blue. And that's not gonna do anything. Because we want three of them over here and one over there. Well, let's just try it. Let's humor it. We're gonna get a red, and that's just gonna be automatically wrong, because the red's at the front. We need a blue at the front. So, okay. Okay, so maybe we don't want it in that order then after all. Like, we do want a toggle at the front and an analyzer. I mean, how's that gonna help even? We could send these through the toggle again and kind of a feedback loop again. I don't know why we'd want to, but we can. No, but we need, like, at the end, we're gonna need two input streams. This is a device that takes one input stream and splits it into two. This is a device that takes one input stream and splits it into two. So either one of these, just one of these goes into this device and then the other one goes out, or like based on an input stream count argument. Like, if I toggle this, then that's not gonna... We need a way to get the reds out, is the thing. Because this red is coming in too fast. So either a toggle or an analyzer has to apply to both of these. So each of these has to go into one device. We can't have one that just goes straight through. It's not gonna work. So wood sending... Well, this starts with a yellow, so maybe this goes to the toggle. So if we filter out the red and add this stream, then maybe that helps get this through, but then this is delayed for a long time before it rejoins up. Let's just see, let me just see if that aligns with my expectations. So then the red gets added to this. That's good. Then a red, and the yellow, it's going to be flipped again. So once again, we want to add the red to this. Okay, so we actually want the red to go in front there, and then it's going to get yellow, blue, yellow, red, red, yellow. It's going to look good. Because now we have yellow, blue, followed by the two reds, followed by yellow, blue, and that's what we wanted. That's what we wanted. Alright, that does it. So there's some subtlety here, but you can use it to reorder blocks into a stream that you like. Like a string, I guess you could say. A block string. Okay. Well, I mean, sure, you probably want this, don't you? Something like that. And then just send half of these over here and half of them over there. But then you need to make sure that half of, it shouldn't matter too much, should it? As long as these halves are appropriate. Like, this should be a short, and this should be a long, probably. And then that should be okay. Well, obviously that's not good. But as long as I can just finish processing these before I get to this other set, we should be good, right? We're gonna need to delay this a bit, but that should be fine. Not quite. That still has to be a bit shorter, or just has to be a bit longer, or something. Okay, so we'll make these go here. Yeah, that should do it. That should delay these long enough that this can come in first. This one just didn't turn the corner, right? Okay, there we go. I think that should result in equitable distribution of blocks. No. No, it doesn't. Why is that? So after all that, why is that? Oh, it's because these aren't, right, that's because these aren't toggled like these are. So we're gonna send a red, a blue, and a red over here, and a blue, a red, and a blue over there, which is not equal. And then this is gonna send an equal number of the appropriate color. It's gonna send all of them. Yeah, because the way this is spaced out, now it's going to send all the blues left and all the reds right. That's not what we want at all. So, actually... Well, the toggle's the only thing that fits here, actually. Yeah, the toggle has to go here. So then the analyzers have to go here. So we have to be a bit more clever about this. Which means, I think, actually, yeah, we're going to have to string these together. I was pairing these two together, like, this follow immediately after this or so, but we're actually going to have to interleave them. I think that's what we have to do. Okay, so this should go straight through. This should also go straight through, but soon afterwards, I think. That might do it. Or no, it's going to have to be this. We still want to keep our numbers the same, right? Let's just see what we get with this. So now, we're gonna send, well, we're gonna have to delay this a bit. Or how'd that happen? Like that. Okay. Okay. So we're gonna get a red, a blue, and a blue sent over on this side, and also a blue, a red, and a blue here, right? And so, and then this should be the reverse of that, the reverse distribution. If I can get this to actually be correct. Well, that's not gonna do it either. Why is that? Okay, so in this first set of sticks, we've sent, we're gonna send... Alright, so we're gonna send a red, a blue, and a blue over here. So that's one red and two blues, followed by one blue and two reds over there. Then in the second set, which I didn't actually calculate, we're gonna send two blues and a red over here, which is wrong. So we want to send a blue and two reds. So we want this to arrive before this, and then that should fix it. So instead of delaying this a lot, we want to only delay it a little bit. So that it follows soon after that set. We wanted to get there before this one. So then delay this by one. And then that should do it. Just reordering this should make the toggler actually work correctly and distribute the load the way we want. Alright, that looks better. Okay. So, alright, so we're making good progress. That's level 28. We started on level 21, I think. No, 22. Yeah, so we did our set of 7 again. And in addition to that, we also looked at level 15 briefly. Alright, so that's probably a fine place to end the episode. Once again, we'll take a peek at number 29. Make everything red. Okay. That looks simple enough, but I'll leave it till next time. But, you know, enforcing conformity is certainly another of our activities in this machine, and it's not really my job to ask questions about why I'm doing the things we're doing. You just have to do them. So, next time, we'll see you then, and hopefully we'll get paid for this.